Hi, I'm Sanjoy Nag. You're watching me on Cine Speaks.
Hello, sir. Congratulations for yours truly. I've seen the trailer and it is beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
I can assure, like, movie is going to be amazing.
It's going to
be lovely. So what was the seed of the idea? What was the seed of the concept?
I wanted to make a love story. I was kind of looking for content. And I wanted to make a love story where in India, you're constantly being told India is a young country. So therefore, it only has space, and all love stories need to be kind of driven around youth and young people. So I was kind of perplexed as to what happens to people who are not considered youth anymore. Do they don't have love anymore left in their lives anymore, or you can't have love stories with them? So then what do you do? So while I was kind of trying to probe and kind of figure out a content to base my next film on, that is when I read Anis Aidi's film, which is called The One That Was Announced. Excuse me. So that this film is actually based on that. And this, I thought, kind of fell into that space that I was kind of trying to explore. So that is where it started, yeah.
It is very unusual concept. It is like a woman is falling in love with a voice. She connects with letters, which is totally different in this era. So how you came up with it? Like, you told the idea of the concept, but what made you like, okay, yeah, idea hai, but I have to make a movie on this. You that could have been anything, but you thought of making a movie. Why? So,
because I thought this is something which has been there. It has been a part of our life. Excuse me. This is something which is not being explored anymore. You know, people are too busy with their smartphones and mobile phones and everything. But this entire art of writing letters to your beloved or to whom you wish to communicate with, that is still dying. You know, it's like a dying art form, writing letters. That was something I had in mind. So I thought, if I'm putting my protagonist in a space like that, why not also get back the template of writing letters? So I just wanted to put these two things together and see if that works out. Frankly, the response that I've got so far from people who've seen the film or the trailer, it seems to have worked out. So that is the basic idea, was that, you know, like, you have this and put them together, put the two together and see what happens.
You could have made this film for a big screen, but you thought of a digital platform. Mm-hmm. Why so?
Because the film that we've made, yours truly, I think it would have got lost in this entire rigmarole of getting Friday release, a number of screens, because obviously we wouldn't afford the number of screens that a film actually needs to kind of make it business-wise viable, financially viable. So that was not possible for us. So we knew we were making a film which is going to be content-driven. Therefore, it was important for us to get a platform like Zee5, OTT like Zee5, and then put it there so that people across the world, you know, like, I think Zee5 is seen in 193 countries or 196 countries. So, you know, people across the world, they see the film and they see it at their own convenience. You don't have to, because it's a small film, if you release it, you probably get a Monday morning 9 o'clock show.
Mm-hmm.
So people don't have to rush to a theater, because nobody will. I mean, and going by the recent trends that I see in my country, people are actually becoming very reluctant to go to theaters. I mean, look at all the fate of the big films, mm-hmm. Which have come in recent times. People have not. They rather prefer to see them on OTTs. And so I thought, why not? Why not have an OTT, you know, sharing my film, sharing our content, and therefore reaching all the people that I want to reach seamlessly without getting into this entire thing of, you know, distribution and all of that. So, yeah, that was the idea. And I thought, and I still think, in future, this is going to be one space that is actually going to generate more interesting content than what we see on the big screen.
It is said that the director is the actual hero of the film. So what is your take on it?
See, film is actually a team effort. Mm-hmm. So the director's job is to be, and I think, you know, especially in India, the director is good only when he's a very good human resource manager. You're basically managing a lot of diverse, divergent human resource. Like, for even in my film, like, we had people from all over the country and even from USA kind of getting involved in this film. So you have to manage that. So if you can do that, you're a good director. I mean, that's the way. I mean, of course, you have an idea, you have a concept, you have everything. But for small films, you have to be prepared to do everything. You know, it's very core unit of, say I'm there and my co-producers are 2-3 people, need to pull and push everything together and then have it in place. So yes, even though the director could be, it is a director's medium and director is a hero, but I don't think a director can function. Okay, the director can bring the idea, I can get the structure, I can have an idea where somebody's writing letters to a voice, is replying, all of that. But then again, I need to also execute that. I need support. That only happens if you have a team which kind of thinks like you do and believes in your films, the way you want to do a film.
Is it difficult to direct a short, like a digital film or a like big screen film? Because on digital platform, the content should be short and crisp. The content should be short and very crisp. So is it difficult or how it is?
I will look at it differently in the sense, whatever you make, whether you make it for the big screen, small screen, whatever, the OTTs, whatever, it has to engage with the audience. If you can make something which is engaging with the audience, it will work. If not, it will not. Even in the digital space, if it's not engaging with the audience, people will flip to some other show that is running on the same OTT or go to some other OTT. Same with theater. I mean, theatrical releases, people will not see it, and it's evident now. People will not see just because you've made a film. If it is not engaging them, if it is not exciting them, if they don't like it, they will not see it. So I think it is difficult, or it is important rather, I should say, to make any content, and I think directors and screenwriters need to get into the space even more, which will engage with the audience. That is, I think, most important at this point of time.
We have Mahesh Bhatt's cameo. So how was it to direct a director?
I think Mr. Mahesh Bhatt, having directed so many films and he's been in the industry for such a long time, he knows what a director goes through because he's primarily a director. So therefore, it was very sweet of him. He knew when to kind of step aside and just be an actor and not a director.
Mm-hmm.
See, there's a lot of energy that he brings onto the set. He's still young at heart and he's all of that. And there was a lot of energy the day he came to shoot for us in Calcutta. His energy was, you know, the energy level just shot up. But as having said that, since he was a director himself, he knew where to step, you know, to draw the lines. He did that. So it was like me directing an actor, Mahesh Bhatt the actor. It was not Mahesh Bhatt the director who was directing. So yeah, it was like directing everybody else. I mean, you know, I'm umpty number of takes, as many takes, and he would tell him, you tell me this, you tell me. I mean, it was a very interactive process. But as I said, I mean, it was just directing an actor, any other actor. I mean,
was it fun directing yours truly, or it went difficult? Was it fun to direct yours truly, or it went difficult?
No, it was always fun. I mean, I love the entire process of making a film. So yeah, I loved it. So it was fun. I mean, fun in my own way. I mean, it wasn't difficult. I mean, also what happens if you use, you know, if you get into this thing of it's being difficult or rough and tough, then you kind of limit yourself. But as a filmmaker, I would only like, even on the sets, I don't go with a very fixed shot breakdown and all that. We like improvise on the set. So the moment all these ideas, or if I kind of get into the thing of, you know, I'm not liking it or I'm not, you know, not enjoying it this much, I will only limit myself. Which is something I definitely want to do. So yeah, I love filmmaking and I love the process of being on a film set. So it is fun, yeah. Picnic.
Lastly, your message to audience.
Please come and watch a film and please don't lose hope. I mean, love is there. Love is something which has been always been there. It will always be there. Give it the time it needs and follow your heart. I mean, don't lose hope and don't make it a very instant thing. Like answers and replies and everything will have to happen this moment or it's over. It's not. It needs the time. It's something you need to nurture. It needs to grow. You have to engage with it. So give it the time that it needs. It will come back and it will enrich you.
Thank you so much and all the best.
Thank you so much.